configuration is created. You can suppress existing features, add new material, add holes, whatever you require. In this case, we want to create the raw material that this block would be cut out of. We will suppress the holes in it as well as the slots, and then create a block that represents the material. The first step is to select the raw material configuration by double-clicking on it. You can then go back to the Feature Manager design tree. You can select any feature you wish to suppress one at a time by clicking on it, then right-click, select Configure Feature, and in this window, the Modify Configurations, you can turn on the checkbox to suppress the feature in the appropriate configuration. In this case, we're going to suppress this hole in the raw material configuration and select OK. If we now go back to the Configuration Manager, we can see two things. The hole has been suppressed. If I double click on the default, the hole should return and there are no rebuild errors. Go back to the raw material configuration. When I suppress features, I can also select the first one, hold shift and select the last one, then right click, select configure feature, and I can suppress the appropriate features all at once to make it a bit quicker. Once again, click OK. We'll see these features are now suppressed. If I go back to the configuration manager, select the default configuration, they will return, and we have no warnings showing us we've done it properly. I'll go back to the configuration manager, double click the raw material, these features now disappear. We're now going to add a new feature to make this look like the raw material required for the part. So we'll select the front plane, create an extrude base from the front plane, look normal to it if you wish. I'm going to use the rectangular feature. And create a rectangle. For this case, the bottom of the rectangle will be collinear with the bottom of the part. I can now add dimensions. I want my raw material to extend 0.1 or 100 thou off of each end. And it will be 3 inches tall. By creating the raw material configuration this way, we're assuming the function of this part is fine, leaving this surface unmachined. I will use the mid-plane extrusion and extrude it 3 inches, leaving the merge result on. Because this feature was created in our raw material configuration, as soon as I go back to the default by double clicking on it, SolidWorks will have suppressed it.